Welcome back to another video. I hope that you're ready because we're gonna check some information today that is very, very important. Muchos de ustedes, chicos, tal vez se encuentran actualmente estudiando y tal vez algunas de esas clases son de inglés. Bueno, el día de hoy te vamos a estar ayudando con un poco de vocabulario para defenderte en esas clases. Más que nada para convivir en el ambiente de inglés y a esas clases sacarle el mayor provecho en tu escuela seglar. Así que I hope that you're ready to take notes to enjoy this lesson because here we go. El día de hoy vamos a estar practicando con un poco de vocabulario que son palabras específicas, frases, desde sencillitas hasta un poquito más elevado, porque qué tal si al momento no estás estudiando algo que requiere el inglés o estés en clases de inglés en tu escuela seglar. ¿Qué tal si tu meta es aprender inglés viviendo en otro país o estudiar la carrera que estás estudiando ahorita en otro país? Bueno, estas frases también te servirán para lo mismo, para que vayas teniendo en el bolsillo todas estas frases básicas y te vayas preparando para esa meta a futuro. Así que aquí estamos. Y recuerda, si no te has suscrito, suscríbete ahora mismo y activa la campanita para que no te pierdas ninguno de nuestros videos. Recuerda que estas lecciones te llevarán cada vez más cerca a aprender inglés. Y si no formas parte de nuestro instituto, ¿qué esperas? LinguaTech tiene muchísimas oportunidades para ti. Así que aquí vamos. English for school. Remember, this is for the classroom environment. So today we're gonna be checking these phrases that you can say on your next English class to maintain the English vibe, to live in English, how we're supposed to be. So remember guys, if you're not used to, I really encourage you to take notes. That is gonna help you a lot in the future when you want to study something or when you forgot some little detail or if you want to practice by yourself. So remember, take notes and here we go. Okay, so first we're going to start with simple words. Maybe some of them you already know them, but it doesn't kill you to practice a little bit more vocabulary with me. And pronunciation. Remember, practice your pronunciation. With practice, everything is possible. So we're going to start with some small words from the vocabulary, okay? So the first one, very basic, pencil. Oh, you're right, right? Pencil. We also have pen or book and notebook. Remember, try to practice and repeat after me so you can practice those aspects of pronunciation that maybe you haven't mastered yet, but we're getting there. Okay, so we continue. Backpack, backpack, bag, classroom, teacher, student, chair, table, whiteboard, desk, uniform, college, bathroom, backyard, elementary school, middle school, high school, university. Remember, these are the levels of study. So first, the first one is kindergarten. Then we go to elementary school. After that, we go to middle school, then to high school, and at the end, university. And after that, there are some specific words for the next degrees, but we're gonna go into further detail later, okay? So that is a very basic vocabulary for like everyday classroom, but we're going to practice a little bit with some vocabulary that even though it has some meaning, but like basic meaning, maybe in college has a different meaning. So we're gonna go further into that. Okay, so we already practiced our vocabulary. Now we're gonna jump to phrases. Okay, now here guys, something that always happens in a classroom is that the teacher wants you to only speak English. And that can be a little bit difficult if you're not comfortable with the language. Again, don't be afraid of making mistakes. Remember that mistakes are your friends, because if we don't make mistakes, how are we going to learn? So don't worry about that. Now, try to use these phrases the next time that you're in an English class. So it's gonna help you a lot and you're gonna be feeling even more and more comfortable with them. And even more confident. So here are some phrases that are going to help you a lot with your English classes. For example, what about when I or you want to go to the bathroom? For example, we can ask, can I go to the bathroom? However, a more formal way to ask that with more respect would be, may I go to the bathroom? Or may I go to the restroom? Like that, you're gonna ask if you can go to the bathroom in a fancier or more respectful way. Now, another could be taking notes. Well, what about if the teacher is explaining? You can ask, hi, can I take notes? That way the teacher knows that you are in fact paying attention, but taking notes. Or what about if the teacher uses word or phrase, silence, or quiet, or sit down? That means, okay, let's pay attention to the teacher. Now, what about if I want to speak English, but I don't know how to say the word that I want to say in my first language? For example, Spanish. My first language is Spanish. So sometimes I would like to know how to say a word. For example, I can ask this way. Teacher, how do you say, and the word. An example could you say. Teacher, how do you say blusa en inglés? Or in English. Teacher, how do you say blusa in English? Well, the teacher would say, yeah, it's blouse. That way you improve or you make bigger your vocabulary, and it's gonna help you a lot. Remember, always ask questions. Questions are also your best friend. Now, another phrase could be, teacher, can I go out? Or I feel sick. Because if you're having an emergency, you would like to tell the teacher that. Okay? So try to practice all these phrases or the phrases that you feel comfortable with on your next class. Okay, we already have words. We already have phrases. Now, the next thing that we have to do is level up. So many of you guys have the goal to go to another country to study something or even to work. Something that is going to help you a lot is to understand some higher vocabulary, okay? So for example, in college, which is like university, you are going to hear the word, I have a paper due tomorrow. The translation would be, tengo un papel que se entrega mañana. Pero eso no tendrá mucho sentido. Entonces, ¿qué significa paper? Bueno, paper, cuando lo utilizamos en un ambiente escolar, significa que tengo un ensayo, un texto o un formato que yo debo llenar o realizar. De esta manera, utilizamos esta palabra que tal vez en un ambiente más común significa simplemente papel. Bueno, en estos casos, en los casos de la escuela, significa este tipo de tareas. We also have the words like essay, or text, or article, or just plain homework. Also, we have exam, or deadline. Have you heard the word deadline? Bueno, en español sería fecha límite, and it's something that you're gonna hear a lot when you are studying something, so it's good for you to understand it. Now, recuerda, si tu meta es estudiar algo de tu interés o trabajar en algún otro país, recuerda que especializar tu inglés será de increíble ayuda. Y claro, buscar información al respecto te va a ayudar muchísimo. Con una meta fija, encontrarás mejores resultados. But still, knowing these phrases is also gonna help you a lot in the classroom environment. Ahora vamos a imaginarnos una situación muy común en la escuela, o en universidades, o en cualquier nivel escolar. Es muy, muy común. Y es a la hora de presentarte. Ahora, vamos a hacer un ejercicio para practicar todo lo que hemos visto hoy. ¿Qué te parece? Con todo lo que has aprendido y el conocimiento de inglés que tienes, vamos a intentar tener una conversación, ¿ok? Now, imagine that we are at school. Let's try this. Hi, my name is Marisa. What is your name? Nice to meet you. What is your next class? Oh, mine is math. Well, my next class starts at 8. When does your next class start? That's nice. Well, I am 21 years old. How old are you? Interesting. Well, my favorite subject at school is history. What is your favorite subject? Nice. Very good. So after this, would you like to study something else? Nice. I would like to study something else as well. Maybe something in history. Good work. Excellent. Remember, trying to have this kind of conversation sometimes is hard because you have to improvise a little. But when you practice, you focus on the things that you need to practice on. For example, si yo estoy teniendo una conversación conmigo en el espejo y quiero decir algo, pero no sé cómo decirlo en inglés, bueno, lo que hago es que investigo. De esta manera ya no me vuelvo a pasar. Y estoy preparando cuando la situación surja. Así que de esta manera te va a ser más sencillo practicar por ti solo. Muy bien, con esto hemos llegado al final de este video. Espero te haya gustado y que sigas practicando tu inglés, porque cada vez estás más cerca de lograr tu meta de inglés. Recuerda que aquí en LinguaTech lo que nos interesa es que tú puedas aprender inglés práctico. Así que si te interesa formar parte del equipo, bueno, pues puedes acudir a tu LinguaTech más cercano o pedir información por nuestras redes sociales. Recuerda que estamos en YouTube, en Instagram, estamos en Facebook, estamos en Twitter. So, whenever you want to get your information, you can do so. Okay? Y recuerda suscribirte para que no te pierdas ningún video y activa la campanita. Además de, dale like a este video si te gustó y deja abajo tu comentario. ¿Alguna vez te has encontrado en estas situaciones donde no sabes cómo actuar en tu clase de inglés o qué decir o cómo pedir ayuda? Es algo muy común y eso pasa mucho en el método tradicional. Por eso aquí en LinguaTech nos gusta aprender de una forma más natural, un poquito más desestresada, sin libros, sin tareas, para que aprender el idioma no se vuelva una carga, se vuelva una experiencia que tú disfrutes al 100%. De esta manera lograrás un aprendizaje significativo, no algo con lo que te cargas porque, uy, si no me lo aprendo, voy a reprobar el examen. No, olvídate de eso. No es la mejor manera de aprenderlo. Así que, si quieres más información, ya sabes dónde encontrarnos. Y, bueno, nos vemos en el próximo video. Y recuerda, con LinguaTech, tú puedes.